ultimate team. Coming up, we've got a good one in store between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Detroit Lions. The Lions come into this one knowing they've got a fight on their hands. This could be one of those war of attrition types of games. So winning the field position battle and the turnover battle are going to be two big keys to seeing who gets out of here with the victory. So let's send you up now to the Queen City of Cincinnati. Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn here in the booth. And Chuck, you take a look at this matchup. I don't know if it's going to be one in the trenches for the quarterbacks out, whatever. It's going to be a good game.
Oh, without a doubt. I can't wait to see the big fellas having him back. We're always spotlighting those wide receivers and quarterbacks and running backs and even the defensive backs. But the big guys, I can't wait to see which one tilts the balance for their team.
Whoosh, the 20. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up the first and goal.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they have plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Now a first down throw. Stafford being chased out left. Toward the pylon, caught. A gain of 9 there. Sets up second and goal.
Everyone has their strengths, Abel. So that means you've got to work on both because you never know which way you're going to get flushed by pressure. In this situation, able to escape to his left and makes an accurate throw.
Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. First throw now for the backup, Breeze. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
And now a critical extra point attempt here. No sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. The drive there only spanning 3 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown for the Lions. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is, the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, Real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
Again, it's Hill. And he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. It's a loss of two, now third down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you get success, you might just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. Oh, across up the football, near his own goal line.
Like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, the teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Here's Kevin Huber now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he's able to get it out of there. Here's Hester. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. Excellent field position here as they take over first and 10. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense. We got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Touchdown. A great effort there. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Lions have taken the lead.
Did you see them hold up four fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
And they will take a 7-point lead now. Kick this one away. Field it about a yard deep. And they'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a first down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here of what could be their final drive. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jadeveon Clowney in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. He's back to throw. And he slides to avoid the hit. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As I talk it over here before what will be an important third down. And the Bengals on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is third and 16. There as it's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Sanders. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. Well, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Right, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed. And a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
And he's able to get this one down to about the 40. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. Now they're with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Second down to the offense in search of 6 yards. Breeze is looking to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great play there. With now two fourth quarter touchdowns. And thanks to the interception, the Lions offense cashes in with 6.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And the lead is up to 14. Zerline out now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And they'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit, ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back in the window. Tell me in the front, let's just go out and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Dump off now to Hill, and he gets on the 29-yard line, brought down there. Call it a gain of 3, and that's going to lead to a third down. Dalton here from the gun. This is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Kyle Ford, And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get to this lead, and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counter punch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. Hard to call this guy a game manager, but that's really all he's needed to do. The running game, fantastic.
And they've actually put themselves in a spot where they're able to close the game out, doing what you would want to do in this situation anyway, run the football. But they don't have to ramp up into it. They're already there. They've been establishing it the entire game.
And they can keep that running theme and get into the locker room with a win. They'll give it here to his running back. Finds a seam inside the 40. Well, he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Detroit. A big play there. Finishing strong with 3 fourth quarter touchdowns. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. Zerline out now to kick this one away. This is Phelan a couple yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Bengals getting set to go. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for five.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Just get out of here. And we'll do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue.